Good morning, my dear students. Today is April 20, 2020, that is Monday, and I am your English teacher, Mr. Sandeep Rai. My dear students, after completing a series of video on the writing skill topic advertisement, now we are back on our literature section, and today we are going to do a chapter number 2 from Flamingo book, The Lost Spring, written by Anise Chung. Chapter number 1, the last lesson we have already completed. Some of you are there who have not seen the video, then you can visit your app EduNext and you can check the link which is available there. Now let's begin our chapter number 2, The Lost Spring, written by Anise Jung. My dear students, this chapter Lost Spring talks about the poverty which is prevalent in different societies of entire country. She has tried to highlight the plight of the life of poor people and the children who are exploited either by their uneducated poor and helpless parents and the society who employ them as child laborers. Actually, when we talk about this particular chapter has a story about the poor rag pickers of Simapuri. My dear students, before proceeding further, I need to talk about few things which will make it easier for you to understand the backdrop of this chapter. Dear students, in class 10, you must have studied in your history topic how Bangladesh was formed. There was a war between India and Pakistan in 1971, and which is also called as the War of Bangladesh's Independence. Okay, India intervened in that war. Actually, Pakistan was divided earlier into Eastern Pakistan and Western Pakistan. In Eastern Pakistan, all the Bengali Muslims, they were facing a lot of atrocities by the Pakistani government, and that's why they requested our then Prime Minister Mrs. Indira Gandhi to intervene. And Indira Gandhi, she sent her forces, and after a few days of war, 90,000 soldiers of Pakistani armies, they surrendered in front of Indian army. And a new nation was formed, which was called Bangladesh. Now, my dear students, a new nation has been formed, but again, there were lots of problems. Problems like unemployment, poverty, these problems were there. And even Bangladesh was severely hit by famine, okay, drought. So that's why many of the people from there, they were forced to leave Bangladesh and enter in India illegally as refugees, and they came to Delhi. The place where Simapuri is situated, it was a huge barren piece of land, and they settled their huts there. And in this way, slowly and gradually, those 10-15 people, they took a shape of a big settlement, big slum settlement with 10,000 rag pickers. Okay, my dear students, so this you need to understand it is very, very important for you. Now, they came to Bangladesh, they came from Bangladesh and settled in Delhi. They got their houses, which were like huts made up of mud houses, tarpaulin and tin roofed. Sanitation was not at all good there. There was no, provision for safe drinking water, no sewage. So, in a way, these poor rag pickers, they were compelled to live a substandard life devoid of any basic or civic amenities. Though they were outskirts of Delhi, they were living at outskirts of Delhi, but they were still leading a miserable life. Delhi, the capital of India, and they were a part of Delhi, but still, when it comes to the living standard, they were miles apart from it. Here, I would like to give you a few questions which comes in examination from these particular section. Let me show you the questions. My dear students, this is the question number 1. Simapuri is situated at the periphery of Delhi, yet miles apart from it. Comment. So this question comes as a 6 marker in board examination. So what is the answer? The answer is that Delhi being the capital of India, and the people, those who are living in Delhi, they have a very high living standard. Okay, if you talk about Delhi, it is a metropolitan city where people, they have very good living standard. People from all walks of society, they come to Delhi in search of employment. But these poor rag pickers, they were living in Delhi. Okay, Simapuri was a part which was at the outskirts. Outskirts means which was at the outer boundary of Delhi, but yet in living standard, in terms of our basic amenities which are being fulfilled by the government, they were miles apart from it in culture too, and even in the living standard too. So these are the points which you need to explain as far as this particular question is concerned. Now let's see question number two. From where do these rag pickers have come from and why? So my dear students, just few minutes ago I explained the answer of this question, that they all have come from Bangladesh because of the famine and drought which severely hit Bangladesh, and their houses and their fields, they all were destroyed. They had nothing to eat. So that's why, in search of food, in search of a proper living environment, they were forced to leave their houses, leave their fields, and come to a place where they have at least a source to earn two times daily bread, and that was India in a city like Delhi. So this is the answer that you need to write down in question number two. Now my dear students, these people, they were illegal immigrants who had come from Bangladesh, but still they managed to get ration cards. Okay, they managed to get ration cards, and even they were able to buy grains. Okay, and how come they were able to get ration cards? Thanks to our politicians. Why? Because politicians, they thought that this is a group of 10,000 people, that means a vote bank of 10,000 people. They did not consider them as illegal immigrants. In fact, they considered them a vote bank of 10,000. So that's why, thanks to our corruption, they provided them ration cards. Okay, and in this way they developed their vote bank there, and now these poor Bangladeshi people, those who were illegal immigrants, again I'm using the word, my dear students, illegal immigrants, okay, but after getting ration card, and even they were provided voter ID cards also, because they were a vote bank, and that's why they were now formally the citizens of India. Now they have got a settlement there, they have got an entire colony set up, but what about the earning source? So both the even elders and children, they resorted to rag picking. Okay, this is the word that you need to understand. They resorted to rag picking, and the garbage for them had two meanings. Garbage for them had two different meanings. My dear student, this is a very important question that comes in board examination. See, what does garbage mean for the people of Simapuri? Okay, my dear student, this question comes as a 2 marks questions. Earlier it was of 3 marks, but after the revision of entire question paper pattern, now the question's weightage has been reduced to 2 marks. So this is now a 2 marker question. Okay, now let's see the answer of it. For elders, it is a means of livelihood, or you can call it survival. Means by picking garbage, they are able to earn a 2 times bread for themselves and for their family. Okay, but for the elders, it holds a different meaning. For elders, it is a means of survival, but for kids, it is a gold mine. Okay, or if I quote the NCERT book, the exact line from the chapter, then it is wrapped in wonder. Why wonder? Because these lump of garbages, they are full of surprises. Why? Because they get sometimes coins from there or currency notes. Even they get sometimes old discarded pair of shoes also. So that's why garbage has two different meanings for the people of Simapuri. For elders, it is a means of survival, and for kids, it is wrapped in wonder, where they sometimes get coins, currency note, and even the discarded shoes also. Okay, now let's proceed. The children of Simapuri, they are deprived of schooling. Why? Because in the slum, there are no schools. They cannot fulfill their dreams, and even the dreams of wearing shoe, that is also a far cry. They are not able to afford even shoes to wear. They are the gang of rag pickers who move in local areas, okay my dear students, barefooted with semi-naked body, collecting and carrying bags full of rags. Why they are barefooted? Because they cannot afford the shoes. In the chapter once, Anish Jung inquired that why you walk barefooted. So what was the answer given by these poor rag pickers? They gave answers that we have shoes, but our mothers, they don't give us the shoes to wear. Reason being, if they will give it to us, then we might lose them. But then Anish Jung thought, that is it the actual reason for them all roaming barefoot here? Then she said no. Actually, the reason of their roaming barefoot is their extreme poverty. These boys are trying to hide their utter state of poverty, and they are giving it a different reason that their mothers have kept it and they are not giving it because they might lose it. But these kids, they cannot afford the shoes, and that's why this is the reason they are walking barefoot. My dear students, among all those ragpickers, there is this lead character, Sahib-e-Alam. My dear students, you need to understand this name, Sahib-e-Alam, as a 6-marker question comes in examination from here only. Okay, so detailed about this entire slide we will be discussing in our next class. Okay, till then you need to read the entire chapter Lost Spring, especially this first part in which we are discussing about Sahib-e-Alam, because Sahib-e-Alam is a very important character, and we'll be discussing at length about each and every aspect of his life. So in the meantime, read the chapter from an NCERT book and the questions which I have given you. Let me show you the questions once again. My dear students, these 3 questions are in your homework. These 3 questions you need to do in your FAIR notebook. Okay. And for your further reference, I have given you this website's link here, which you can visit for your further reference. You can find the detailed notes of this chapter from this website. Till then, stay indoors, stay safe, and keep enjoying classroom away from school program. Have a good day.